What a child gamer shifter here. Welcome back to Mafia 2. Last time I last left off, I thought the sister was becoming disrespectful. Like, after I went there, basically set your husband straight, and basically said, next time that he abuses you, I'm going to kill him. It's like, don't come near us again. Like, ungrateful little bitch. But, what are you going to do, you know?
Joe, don't tell me you're not home. Let's go. You better not be passed out. Come on!
Hold your horse. I'm coming.
Oh, you barbecuing in your underwears?
Yeah. Can I come in?
Oh, yeah, of course. I'll fix you a drink.
What the fuck?
Nice, ain't it?
What the hell happened to this place?
Yeah.
I spruced the joint up a little. What do you think?
Yeah, it's really,
looks better.
Different.
Yeah, huh? I decorated it myself.
So what the hell happened? Here, take this.
Those crazy fucking Micks.
What about them? What'd they do?
They tried to fucking kill me.
What?
And they burned my fucking house down.
All my clothes, all my cash. So what do you now do? I'm pissed.
You want to go deal with the mix right now?
Hell yeah.
Damn right I do.
All right, relax. Have a drink. Let me make a few phone calls. And take a look at my closet. Unless you want to go on a rampage in your skivvies.
Thanks.
I don't mind doing it in my skivvies, but it'd be too much effort. I don't get the legs to pull it off.
Ah, great.
Hey, it's Joe.
A fucking clown suit.
Yeah, I know.
Now, this place deserves to be burned down. Wow, kitchen's big too.
Point this house down. I want to know who they are and where they're operating.
Well, the bed's not too bad.
Hey, you're gonna have a lot worse to worry about if you don't tell me. Mickey Desmond. Oh, he is. Well, that explains it.
Pink.
Where is he now?
Ugh. Hurting my eyes.
I know the place. All right, thanks. Hey, you finally got some style. I'm gonna want that shirt back, by the way. They don't make treads like those no more.
Yeah, there's a reason for that, you know? Where are we going?
The Hill of Tara, the Mick joint in Kingston. Come on, I'll tell you the rest in the car. Get in.
Burnt my house. My money. Oh, I'm definitely pissed.
All right. So you heard anything about the Micks lately?
Nah, nothing. Why?
The Micks got themselves a new boss. Name's Mickey Desmond. There's a few other guys who want to take his spot. So he's trying to show everybody that he means business.
What the hell
does he now?
Brian O'Neill.
Shit.
He was Desmond's cousin.
I should have known.
My money's on him being down at that shithole joint right now. Laughing it up with the rest of those fucking yo-yos.
So let's get over there and deal with him.
That's the plan. Sounds like there ain't many of them left. So I guess we should just storm the place, surprise the shit out of him.
I like this plan. Assholes burnt my fucking house down.
Relax, we'll be there in a minute. Shit, you're gonna need a piece. I almost forgot.
Yeah, if you got one, that'd be good. If not, I'll just beat him to death with my bare hands. It makes no difference to me.
Should be one in here somewhere. Here it is. Here you go.
Thanks.
What is this, the Indianapolis Speedway?
Take it easy, I'm in a rush.
Yeah, I want to try to avoid the last video. Well, a tester video. I was trying, then I got started getting chased by a copper because I'm going over the speed limit. Speed limit. And, yeah, I want to try to avoid that. We're gonna try to avoid it this time. I'm smelling lunch. Cooking right now. That's great.
Did you not see that light turn red? Ready, Vito? Come on, let's go get these fucks.
I told you, I chased him, but I lost him. The coward ran away, but I'll find him. And when I do...
You were the one who ran away, asshole.
Fuck. You've got some balls.
Yes, I do.
Going in. Shit.
I chased him, but I lost him. The coward ran away. But I'll find him. And when I do...
You were the one who ran away, asshole.
Fuck. You've got some balls.
Yes, I do.
You're fucking dead! Back me up, Vito. You shoot like my sister. Come on, think of something. Hurry up here.
No, you shoot like your sister.
On your bad side.
Sorry for barking in the background. Ah, shit me.
Hey, there's more of them in that car. Let's go, they're getting away.
All right, come on, you drive.
I don't want to drive. Damn it. Damn, coppers.
Come on, Vito, fast. We're gonna lose them.
I'm trying. You drive, you fat son of a bitch.
Come on, let's just get out of here.
Fine, I need a drink anyway.
Well, that takes care of that, huh?
Yeah, but don't give me my house back.
Don't worry. Business is looking good.
You'll
have to cash for a new one real
quick.
Yeah, I sure as hell hope so.
All right, let's go back home.
So it's okay if I crash on your couch, right?
I can do one better than that. Here, take these keys. They're from Marty's apartment. I'm trying to get rid of it right now for his mother. So, you might as well use it while I do.
Thanks. I guess.
Don't thank me, buddy. You're too old to be sleeping on my couch. Plus, I just bought the thing. I don't want you lousing it up. Marty's apartment's over in Oyster Bay. So you feel better now?
Not really. What we did back there doesn't even start to make up for
it. Hey, all that stuff they got pointed up is just things, Vito.
Just things. Those are my things, Joe. Why do you think I do the shit we do anyway? It's to buy things. You know, suits, cars, broads, houses. Now I'm back to scratch. And all my damn cash was in that house, too. I promised myself I'd never be poor again. And never fuck a wharf rat like no man.
Hey, I understand. Don't worry, we'll think of something. You'll be back on your feet in no time.
The glass is always fucking half full with you, isn't it?
That's the best way to keep it, my friend. Good God, what the hell are those damn dogs barking at this time? Jesus Christ.
What is this, the Indianapolis Speedway?
Shit, should be. Where the hell is Oyster Bay at? You shitting me. On my way, white ass car. Bitch ass.
What are you trying to kill us?
Yeah, I'll see you around, I guess.
See you, buddy. Sorry about tonight.
Thank you. out of my way, you white honky ass Chevrolet driving motherfucker. Man, lunch is making me salt, making me hungry. What the hell are they actually barking at? Bloody hell.
Fucking dump. God, I wish I had the cash for a hotel. Fuck, this is creepy.
Sure is. Chapter 12. But this is where I'm going to call it. Wait, oh shit, this has only been 12 minutes. That's been longer. See, gift. Feels longer, though.
My house burned to the ground, along with almost every penny I had. There was even some trouble with the cops, but Eddie took care of that. And since I didn't have any insurance, I had to live in this shithole of an apartment till I could get back on my feet. At least I managed to save Leo. He disappeared without a trace. I doubt Frank Vinci even knew where he went. And even though Henry failed to deliver on the contract, Eddie still brought him in when he heard Leo had skipped town. Me and Joe had a new partner. Hey.
Listen, I'm setting up something big. I want you to come in on it. If you're interested in hearing more, come meet me at Lincoln Park and bring a piece.
Okay. I'll see you there.
Damn, I'm cashless. I'm broke. Life in a nutshell, isn't it? I might want to make a little detour to the body shop. All of that stuff that I worked so hard for, gone. Isn't that just great? Oh, here's one.
Hey, Vito. Good afternoon. Vito, just tell me what you need.
Damn. How's it
doing business with you?
I don't have enough money to repair a car. All right, great. That's great. Can't drive that car. Well, I might need to pick up a piece, like you said. I don't want to check if I have a gun here. Way too risky. I got one. Yeah, I definitely got one.
Hey, here he comes.
Hey!
What's up?
Hey, Vito. Take a seat. Alright, listen. I've been doing some research into Carlo's business.
So?
So, the only reason he had Clemente killed was because he was selling dope too, and he was stealing his customers. Now he just needs to get rid of one last obstacle. The one guy who could fuck things up and ruin his plan to become the main supplier for the whole city. Frank Vinci.
Where'd you get all this?
I talked to a few people I trust.
Okay, so what does this have to do with us?
Of course, if he can do it, why can't we? A kilo of heroin costs $2,500 over in France. Then it's another $1,000 to get it here.
And?
And we pick up 11 grand for just driving the stuff to the dealers. That's $7,500 profit a kilo.
Yeah, but what about Falcone?
Carlo won't find out. And even if he does, he'll just threaten us and demand a cut.
All right, but if Carlo's the only big supplier in the city, where are you going to buy the stuff from?
I'm way ahead of you. What do you two know about the Tongs?
The Chinks?
Some kind of organization for Chinese immigrants, right?
That's what I said, the Chinks.
Right, but it's also a front for their other operations. They run the Chinese quarter, and they keep to themselves. But some of them are interested in doing business with outsiders, and they need middlemen since most people are afraid to deal with them.
And we're the middlemen.
Yep.
Basically.
It's 10 kilos to start.
For how much?
35 grand.
And we can sell it for...
110.
Nice.
Okay, well, where the hell are we going to get our hands on 35 grand?
I know a loan shark. The Yid over on Palisade. I think a loan is 35, we give him 45 back. Now that means our take is over 20 grand a piece. Not bad for just moving the shit from one place to another.
But you know, who's gonna end up using this crap?
What do you care? As long as it isn't an alley.
Because Vinci was right. Drugs are bad news, they kill people.
Look, only idiots do drugs. Deadbeats and losers. If they want to kill themselves so badly, I'd gladly help them out. Especially for 20 grand. I got buyers in the ghetto. They'll take care of the distribution. So we don't need to worry about that. Is in or not?
I'm in.
I'm in. Ah, don't be stupid, Vito. 20 fucking grand in one afternoon.
When?
Right now. If we don't take the offer, the Tongs will just find somebody else.
Come on, Vito. It'll be a piece of cake.
Let's go see Bruno, then. Vito, how about you run us all down there? He's on Palisade Street.
Okay, let's go.
Pay a visit to the Lone Shark, Southport. Gotta be shitting me.
who's this guy we're gonna see, Henry?
His name's Bruno. He's one of the only guys in town who could do a loan this big.
What if he doesn't give it to us, then what?
Then the deal's off. But don't worry, I know this guy. He'll give us the money.
There ain't nobody else we can get this kind of money from?
There's three of the guys I know of. But if you want to ask Carlo or Frank Vinci for 35 grand, be my guest.
Yeah, no thanks.
Who's the third guy?
He ain't in business no more. Somebody blew up a room full of his guys and shot him point blank in the face with a Tommy gun.
Oh, that guy.
Come on, we said we wasn't gonna talk about that.
All right, so, Henry, what is this guy, rich or something?
I think he gets his money from some of the bosses from out of town who sit on a commission.
Yeah? Oh, shit.
Yeah, which is why we can't stiff the guy. Besides, we gotta keep this quiet.
Don't we trust him?
Sure. Wise guy's been borrowing money from this guy forever. As long as we pay him back on time, we won't have a problem.
What do you got? Inversion to red lights?
Keep saying it, but I don't give a shit. It's a video game.
Okay, guess this is the place.
Pardon me, handsome.
So do we come back here?
Hi, fellas. We're here to see Bruno.
Hiya, Henry. If you got guns on you, put them down there. I gotta search you.
Hey, here's that guy that we saved.
Hey, Bruno.
Hello, Henry. So, to what do I owe the pleasure of your company today?
I need 35 grand in $20 bills.
Oh, that's a lot of money, Henry. A lot of money. Tell me, why should I give that much to a small-time guy like you, huh? Convince me.
I got a sure thing. You'll have 45 by the end of the week.
What kind of sure thing?
Sorry, Bruno. That's a trade secret.
Then 45 is not enough. I'd be more comfortable with 65.
It's a bit steep, even for you. 50's all I can do.
Henry, I have no guarantee I'll get my money back. And you have nowhere else to go. So, how about 60? Don't think of it as interest. It's more like my cut of the profits.
55, final offer. Anything more than that, it's not worth my time.
Deal. I'll give you $35,000 today, and you'll give me $55,000 by Friday. If you don't pay it back by then, the debt goes up by 10,000 every week.
You'll get it by Friday.
Okay. Isaac, prepare $35,000 in $20 bills. Now, you know I trust you, Henry, but if you screw me, remember these wise words from the Bible. And my wrath shall wax hot. And I will kill you with the sword, and your wives shall be widows, and your children fatherless.
Exodus, chapter 22, verse 24.
I'm impressed. You don't seem like the church-going type. But just remember, the money isn't mine. So even if you get rid of me, that doesn't get rid of your debt. So no funny business, okay, boys?
Sure, Bruno.
Thank you, Isaac. You want to count it, Henry?
I trust you.
I'll take your word for it, and I'll bring it back on Friday along with your cut.
I hope so. Good luck, boys.
I feel like we just got gypped. No, our car is this way.
Nice job, Henry.
Of course. I told you give us the dough, didn't I?
How come you know the Bible so good, Henry? You read it or something?
Bruno always uses the same quote. I go to church on Sunday, so I asked the priest one time.
You go to church?
Yeah, and I can understand why you don't. They use big words, there's no hookers, and the food's lousy.
Yeah, that pretty much sums it up.
Jeez, I ain't been there since 45.
What? That time your mother made you go to confession?
Yeah, that time she smacked me for checking out some chick's coolie. God rest her soul.
How about you, Joe? How long's it been?
Easter.
Ah, that ain't too bad.
1941.
I take that back then. You're going straight to hell.
Just figuring that out now?
Don't worry. I'll save seats for the both of these. You know, I heard about a loan shark named Bruno once. Must be the same guy.
Yeah? What'd you hear?
Well, you know Mickey the Crab, right?
What, the guy who cleans the bathrooms at Carlos' joint?
Yeah, the guy who's only got a finger and a thumb on his left hand. Guess how that happened? I heard he owed a lot of money to some yid from Southport. Get my drift?
Oh, right. I get the picture.
Haha, don't worry, though. Crab's a moron. Not like that's gonna happen to us.
Don't get cocky, fat ass. But this is where I'm gonna call it for this video. I'm gonna continue this later. Until next time, I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace and rock on.